We are heading to CrossFit North Atlanta's proposed location, which we're almost there. We're meeting some contractors to look at HVAC stuff and a couple final touches. It is our first move. We celebrate our fourth year anniversary about a month ago. Look at that. It's dirty. This is a dirty damn car. So, boom.
Oh, so this is the box.
Hell yeah. Now we're talking. This is four times the square footage. Man, it's just right.
Fucking
love it.
How long have you been looking at this particular spot and planning around it?
Dude, we started this process at least 3 or 4 months ago, and we actually looked at it and then moved on and then came back to it. You know,
it's like a
house or a car or a date. Yeah, we circle back around and you don't. They actually have a new commercial about it where it's like they show this couple this space and they're like, oh, it's not like this, and then they look at like 10 other hell holes and they come back and they're like, we'll take it. It really is the best calibration of not too much. Once again, we're in that kind of space purgatory, you know, that 5,000 to 8,000 feet or 5,000 to 10,000 feet. We looked at a lot of vertical space or narrow. So this is kind of wide open. Got the high ceilings, yet it doesn't have that feel like, here's the way I look at it. Close your eyes. Just kidding. You're at a party in college, right? And you go to the event facility and everybody's bunched in the corner like a fucking high school dance, right? That same party goes to the Holiday Inn and it's a rager because it's tight quarters, right? Think about all those energy cells bouncing off of tighter anyway. So you get too big and it just kind of like, that's what I really like about our space now, actually tighter.
That's like the Holiday Inn.
It's the Holiday Inn, you know? Which, and go break some beds. I have a great kill record of breaking beds.
Yep.
So, you really get that intimate feel. That's what I love about it. And it's easy to get lost. If you can hear echo, energy is, mojo is dissipating with that echo. Would you agree? Okay.
What else do you have to do to kind of make this building ready to be a gym?
Great question, and it's taken four long, expensive, painful years to figure that out. It's like asking a mom, like, what needs to go in that bedroom for your five-year-old, right? Well, hey, 4 years of raising that little dude. I noticed the little dude, little effer. It is 4 years in the making. So, for example, you know, you run these workouts 100 or 300 times, you know, to start understanding this is the kind of flow that you need, whether it's racks, things that, you know, wall ball holder, medicine ball holders, or, you know, whether to have, you know, stationary squat racks or portable squat racks. It's all in my head. When you sit down on a blank piece of paper, it's like back in the day when you're designing golf courses, you know, it's just fun. But there's some basic, definitely some things that I've learned and that we want to we'll be taking in here. First of which is, I am not, right, at this point in the game, I can't be making all of our shit, you know? I spent more time, I put up every pull-up bar, installed every mat. You know, this time, they're doing the office renovation, and this space is pristine for us to come in. And that's makes it, we spend the better part of 3 years dismantling a building to make it work. We're coming in now with a dismantled building. Yes, sir.
Time to talk to our contractor.